Hey everyone, Road Breach here, and welcome to Movie Time Christmas Edition. It's been a long time since I've done one of these, but I will do more as soon as I can. I've just been caught up with my new job at my local BJ's, so I haven't been in the right frame of mind to make videos. But hopefully I can bring you jolly old subscribers some Christmas cheer by reminiscing on some Christmas classics.
So let's check our lists and get this show on the icy road.
Santa baby, slip a sable.
The Polar Express may not be one of the first Christmas movies that comes to mind when you think of them, but it's still one heck of a Christmas movie that I loved as a kid. The animation still holds up to this day. All the characters are very well animated, and the scenery looks true to life. The one thing I'm not crazy about is how most of the main characters aren't named, with the only exception being Billy. Also, I love this train. It's so freaking cool looking. Plus, it's magical. I think I'd have a field day in the car with all the abandoned toys. I already have a lot of toys in my room, but I do think that one robot toy looked pretty cool. Plus, I love the depiction of the North Pole. Also, a little off topic, but one thing I found pretty cool is that the voice of the know-it-all kid, Eddie Deezine, also voiced Ped in Transformers Robots in Disguise 2015. Overall, just a solid and fun little family flick to watch on Christmas.
Santa baby, a 50-foot convertible too.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer is probably the first movie that comes to mind when you think of iconic Christmas movies. While the publication Now This might see this harmless Christmas movie as problematic, I see it as an entertaining and harmless Christmas movie that's worth preserving for generations to come. This movie fascinated me as a kid because of the fact that it was stop-motion animation, which is what made me pursue this medium and had me experiment with it years later. And I love the fact that this particular medium has become a staple of Christmas movies. While the animation here is pretty dated by today's standards, it's still packed to the brim with charm, and I can't help but love it. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer is an iconic Christmas special for very good reason. It has memorable songs, likable characters, charming animation, and a good narrative that helps regale the story of acceptance for those who are different from the majority.
Baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight.
Klaus is probably one of the most standout examples of innovative technology pushing forth. The traditional animation with the computer-generated shading is a wonderful approach to 2D mediums like this. But pretty visuals isn't all this movie has going for it, because the aberrations they made to the Santa Claus mythology works well here. While it did tick me off that the postman's father sent him to a crappy town as a punishment, it's good that everyone was able to get their town fixed. Just a solid and innovative Christmas movie that's worth a watch.
Think of all the fun I missed.
The Christmas Chronicles isn't perfect, but it's still pretty fun to watch. Ted and Katie are likable characters in their own right, but I didn't think they had much development throughout the movie. Kurt Russell as Saint Nick himself was a great casting choice. I like the idea of a svelte Kris Kringle. The elves were pretty cute too. I really liked their designs. My biggest problem with the movie is just the fact that they didn't actually need Santa's hat to transport through chimneys. Losing the hat is what necessitated the need for them to go on this big adventure in the first place. The special effects for the reindeer weren't that great, to be totally honest, but they did resemble the real thing closely enough, so it's not like they didn't try at least. That musical number was pretty good too. I'm surprised that Kurt Russell can sing, or maybe that was a voice double, I don't know. Besides that, Christmas Chronicles is still a fun little joyride that's worth a watch, even with its flaws.
Santa baby, I want a yacht, and really that's not a...
Frosty the Snowman is another Christmas tale that meets the criteria for an iconic Christmas special worth preserving for generations. I remember watching it every December back at my old house. When I saw how he was made, I was a little confused as to how they built him. His arms and legs are made of snow, his mouth is just an indent when he's not alive, and his nose is a button. But hey, that works fine. This theme song is great too.
Frosty the Snowman was a jolly happy soul, with a corncob pipe and a button nose and two eyes made out of coal.
Frosty the Snowman.
Some magic that old silk hat they found. Oh, when they placed it on his head, he began to dance around.
I like the idea of Frosty leaving after Christmas is over, even if it's a long wait for him to come back. The animation holds up pretty well too, having a great art style and fluid movement. All of this culminates in another great Christmas film that I would recommend to anyone looking for nostalgic Christmas specials. I've been an angel all year, Santa. The Year Without a Santa Claus is another great little Christmas flick by the same company as Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. One thing that my little kid brain couldn't help but notice was that this Santa and Rudolph Santa had different designs, but it didn't make me enjoy it any less. In fact, the extra detail in the characters is a welcome change. The plot is a little odd though. Santa gets sick, and their answer to this is to bring warmer weather to the North Pole and make it snow in the South. And after doing some research, I found that the North Pole is just a big sheet of ice that contracts in warmer weather. I'm not here to be a Debbie Downer.
You're a downer!
But I'm just calling it as I see it. But even though it's not the epicenter of logic, it's still an entertaining romp with some great songs and likable characters. Two of my favorite characters would definitely have to be the Miser Brothers, and I really like the song that goes with each of them.
I'm Mr. White Christmas, I'm Mr. Snow. Touch. Turns to snow in my clutch. I'm too much.
I'm Mr. Green Christmas. I'm Mr. Sun. I'm Mr. Heat Blister. I'm Mr. 101. They call me Heat Miser. I'm too much.
The fun jazzy ballad sung by each of them is well performed, and the brassy instrumentals are very well done. Even though Santa makes the brothers out to be malevolent beings, they're actually pretty accommodating towards visitors. The most hostility they ever show towards anybody is just a little quarrel between each other, which is something that me and my brother do all the time. And even though they're hesitant to do Mrs. Claus's bidding, they eventually work something out and allow each other to share their territory. They certainly have a better relationship than Florius and Moltorb, that's for sure. But the whole package is a fun little movie that I would highly recommend. While these weren't all the Christmas movies I saw, these are some of the most prominent examples that I could think of. Wherever you are, I hope you have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Thanks for watching, and gotta zoom.
Santa baby, slip a sable under the tree.